welcome to the DeVore Fidelity YouTube channel. I'm in my office here in the factory called Monkeyhaus, and today's video is going to be a bit of a hybrid. It's going to be part tour, where I'm going to talk about one of my very favorite pieces of art in here, and it's going to be part record recommendation, because I'm going to be talking about one of my very favorite pieces of music. And they're both called Black, Brown, and Beige. The piece of art is on the wall up here behind me, Black, Brown, and Beige. They are portraits of Duke Ellington. They're hand printed on rice paper. And the piece was made by an artist, Peter Bodge, who is a friend of mine. He works out of Massachusetts. And I got these just about 10 years ago, and it was a barter. And when I saw that he had made this piece, I immediately wanted it. And we came to make a deal. I love this piece. Not only because it's beautiful and because it was made by a guy who I admire quite a bit. He's a great guy. He's a jazz drummer as well, so we bonded a little bit on that. Not that I'm a jazz drummer, but I did dabble around in drums a little bit when I was younger. He made me a mixed cassette of his favorite jazz drummers. How cool is that? So we worked out a trade, and I got these, and these were among the very first pieces of art I hung up in my office. I absolutely love them. They're based on a composition by Duke Ellington called Black, Brown, and Beige that he wrote in 1943 for his debut concert at Carnegie Hall. It was the first time Duke Ellington had played at Carnegie Hall, and at that point, very little jazz had happened there. The Benny Goodman Orchestra had played there a couple of times in the 30s. Beyond that, there was very little else at the time. So it was a big deal. Duke knew clearly that it was a big deal, and he wrote his biggest, most ambitious piece of music. Still, I mean, it was his biggest and most ambitious piece of music he wrote for his entire career. It's a big piece. It's an orchestral piece, but within the jazz idiom. And at the time of writing, it was Duke Ellington's portrait of Black Americans at that time. It's an incredible and beautiful piece of music. It went over really well with the sold-out crowd at Carnegie Hall, but the critics were not surprisingly confused. The jazz critics said it was too long. What is this weird long-form stuff you're doing? The classical critics had trouble figuring out what the hell it was. It wasn't out of the blue completely. Gershwin had made some hybrid jazz classical pieces, but this was really a bit of a different thing. It was it's a really serious piece, and it was coming from one of the most popular leaders of a big band at the time, and he had mega hits. I mean, his swing songs were mega hits. Take the A Train, and so this was a serious left turn for Ellington. And he realized it, and I think he took the criticism a little bit too seriously. Well, in hindsight, he clearly took it too seriously. And he apparently never really performed this in its entirety again after the few concerts in the 40s. He never recorded it. They released a really shortened version of it on 78 in the 40s. But then in 1958, he did a slight rework of the piece. And that's what this record is, along with the unbelievable Mahalia Jackson singing the two vocal passages on the second side. And it's astounding music. It is so good. Highly recommended piece of music that is really, unfortunately, not as well known as, in my opinion, it should be. Thanks for watching. It's great to see everyone here. And I will see you soon at the next video. Thanks. Bye.